Mike Miahuni, thank you very much for being with us again. The selection of the shorts in this year's Berlin Film Festival are renegotiating the gender dynamics again, but this time in a very, very eclectic selection of films.
This year, what really struck me most was to see that it's, I mean, gender is one thing, but doing it in a daily life is another thing. There's an incredible movie from Spain, Suc de Cendria, where we watch a couple, we see a couple in love. They are in love, and she's trying to regain her orgasm. And it's beautiful because you never see something explicit, but you feel the love, you see the love, and you know that without love, you cannot do that.
She's tried to regain her lost libido since she was raped.
Here we go. And he is supporting her. And he's supporting her even if she at one moment gets like normal hysterical, you know, like freaks out, but he still is there.
It's a very intimate journey.
It's a very intimate journey, and the director mentioned the way, because I was curious, how do you direct such intimacy, no? Because you never see something, but you still feel the intimacy, it's all there. So she said she worked with meditation, and she guided the actors through meditation to this point of being with yourself and letting yourself go. No, beautiful, very beautiful. But, you know, this is one of 24 films that compete for the Golden and Silver Bears. And most of them really work on this everyday base, and we won't have change in society or elsewhere without the everyday life. So we have to do these everyday steps. And cinema is beautiful in this sense that we can really see how other people do it. So there is this film, All in a Mardi Gras Day, from the United States, where we follow this black American who, you know, had been on drugs and everything, but found that he can, if he stitches, and he's making up incredible costumes for the Mardi Gras Day.
Big golden wings. Yeah.
Big golden wings, but he's also the chief for the community. So his everyday life is showing that it's possible to be a chief, a leader, and you know, like, be a father, and he never had a father. So he becomes a father, and not as a figure, as an image, as something, you know, like, oh yeah, my big father, blah, blah. No, he has to do it, and he's running the business with the big, big family. Another film also about gender, and leads us to the other topic in terms of the post-war zone in Bosnia-Herzegovina.
Yeah, everyone is talking about the films about Bosnia-Herzegovina in Berlin.
Yeah, it's incredible. I mean, 20 years later, but now it's on the table. Wow. We had a Golden Bear winner from Bosnia in 2006, Jasmila Svanic, with Grubovica, but she made a short documentary in 2000 about a woman looking for her children following these groups of who open up the mass graves, because she knew the day the military took her son away, he had rubber boots on and rubber, you know. So this already shows, this small documentary shows the sensibility of Jasmila to be able to get via the regards in between the people to have this certain atmosphere, which leads to the question, how can you live after what had happened? The film I was talking about, thinking about, is also Nemes from Kosovo. It's the first time ever that a film from Kosovo comes here. And there you see these old men, patriarchal father figures, who build the same houses for their sons, not for their girls, but for their sons in the landscape. They want them, you know, to come back. But we are further in society, so the family comes back for, you know, matrimonio, for when people get married. And
occasionally, but not to settle down.
No, but of course they don't tell their fathers. Because this is the only thing, you know, which, or perhaps they speak, but I think it's in the air. Fathers feel, but still they build. You see the houses in the landscape, empty houses everywhere. It's strange, you know, but it also shows that something is breaking apart, you know, something is changing.
Yeah, I'd like to pick your mind. You have, like, from your vast experience, I'd like to know, how long does it take for a generation of filmmakers to talk about traumas, because this is very much debated in the films shown in the short section.
Filmmakers are part of a generation. They are only perhaps voices, you know, like artists are voices for a generation, kind of. But I think it seems to me as it at least it takes two generations that more and more people. I mean, Jess Miller started straight out after the war. She made her first films, you know, it's clear. And now she will shoot Srebrenica this summer about the big massacre that happened there.